Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of the When
Did I Ask
podcast. We're proudly sponsored by Bill Athletic, Urban Health and Fitness, and Safe Space Connections. Cue the intro. Today we thought we'd have a little bit of a chat about friendships, good ones, bad ones, and normalize.
Talking about it.
I feel like we're from a group of friends where we kind of just banter a lot. But at the same time, I think it needs to, like, we should be able to talk seriously about toxic friendships.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's go.
How's your week been?
Yeah, it's been good.
You get up to?
Absolutely nothing. Nah, started to train again, get back into the routine of things.
Yeah.
Obviously,
we started a Strava app.
Yep.
For Titans. We are required to do 3 2-kilometer runs a week.
And Crystal wants to be a part of the leaderboard, and she always wants to win. In-house competition. So she wants to win the 6Ks every week.
We're just preparing for our season to come, all right?
Negativity.
That's you, negativity. Anyway, how important are friends to you?
Yeah, they're really important.
Friendships?
I feel like they're the family that you get to choose outside of your own family. They help shape the people that we are. Obviously, throughout life, you get to go through so many different types of friendships, meet different people, but I feel like they add a lot of value to your life, and they're kind of like the outside family kind of thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, what about you?
I just think they're a group of people that, so if you don't have family, you can lean on, like, friends to open up to, do things with if you're not comfortable doing with actual family. Yeah, and they just bring a huge impact on your mental health.
Yeah, that's very true.
Yeah. What are your thoughts on toxic friendships? And what do you think it looks like? And have you ever been a part of one or two, three, four, five?
I'm actually a part of one now. No, what it looks like, to me, it probably just looked like a UFC fight.
just
emotionally, physically, and everything draining.
Yeah,
that's exactly what it would look like to me, without the actual, like, look of it. So it's all internal. Well, that's what it would look like for me anyway. What about you?
Just a lot of arguing, jealousy. I don't know.
Those are definitely the traits.
Yeah,
of a toxic one.
I don't know. I've never been a part of one, but if I could imagine it, it'd be a lot of mental, emotional abuse, some physical abuse maybe. I don't know. To an extent, though.
I don't think I've been a part of a physical, like, abusive.
Well, anything past mental, emotional, and then you add the physical. Oh fuck, that's domestic violence.
Yeah, we're done. We're done, and if that's a friendship, wow.
I don't know how.
But I'm yeah.
I don't know how people live with that.
I mean, I feel like it's very easy to get yourself into, like, a situation like that. You obviously, like, depending on the person that you are. Mm-hmm. I know for myself that I'm like, I like to try help fix people, and at times I've kind of become consumed by everything. All their insecurities, and I kind of, like, you know, just try and answer all the questions without having the answers to the questions. So it puts me in, like, a vulnerable position to, I don't know, hurt them. Mm-hmm. And then in return hurt myself. So yeah, it's very easy.
If you open up like that and you trust the person.
Yeah, well, when someone's, like, hurt, I feel like you generally try to just, like, fix it. So it's a lot easier to open up. Because you want them to be vulnerable as well.
Hey, that's your problem. Nah.
I know, well, some people aren't like that. I wish.
No, I'm kidding.
I wish.
I'm willing to help anybody.
Just don't get caught up in it, I reckon.
Too emotionally invested, that's all it was.
Oh, I've heard that line lots of times. But yes, you are correct.
Have you been a part of one?
Yeah. I've probably been a part of a few.
Yeah.
What's
your most, well, I don't know, recent? Should I say recent?
I don't think recently. Recently I haven't been a part of one. I have been a part of a few. But they've probably, like, shaped me into the person that I am now.
Do you still keep in contact with this person?
No, I don't keep in contact with them anymore. I think it was, like, not a mutual decision, but it was both, like, on both of our behalves. I don't think it was healthy for us to stay in contact.
Was it?
But at the same time, it was not, like...
An easy process, hard process?
Nah, it was hard. Like, it was progressive over, like, a few years. It took us to, like...
What things were hard?
Letting
go.
The hardest thing was probably, like, coming to terms with that, like, the friendship's not there anymore. Like, it's dead. And then letting that go. But then, obviously, I have, like, kids.
Mm.
So, at the same time, it was, like, trying to, I guess, understand that they did, like, my kids deserve better. So, I thought that, you know, that was the right thing to do, was to stay in it. But then it came to a point where I was just, like, if... it's not working for me, they're not getting anything out of it kind of thing. Why should I keep them questioning, like, their worth, so to speak? So then I just thought, as a mum, I had to do what's right for my daughters, and cutting it was probably the best thing.
So she's your daughter's godmother. Apparently, that's what you told me. Do you think she should still be a part of her life regardless of what you guys have been through?
Yeah, definitely. Like, I never wanted to take that away from them, because they obviously love her very lot, and I genuinely believe that I've exhausted all my options in trying to
I remember a few times this year, like, even I've only been here since February, but I think I remember you a few times trying to reach out to her, even like the times that your daughter's been in hospital and stuff, like, your daughter's asked for her, and then you've contacted her, but she hasn't, like...
Yeah, I think that's the hardest thing, is, like, you know, when your kids, like, when they ask for somebody, you kind of want to fulfill all their wishes.
Yeah.
And so, like...
Well, you've done that.
But I think that, like, now I'm like, okay, I've tried all of that, we've done that, it's not working... And I can't keep, like, making promises with the girls and they're not kept, kind of thing. So
Has she tried to reach out to you guys?
I wouldn't say she hasn't.
That's a bit confusing. Has she or not?
After I've asked.
What do you mean?
So, like, it's been like, hey, Falan's in hospital or whatever.
Yeah.
And then it's been, like, after that.
Just named your name. Yes.
I'll cut it. Or, like, one of the girls have been in hospital, and then blah, blah, blah. And then she's contacted them afterwards. But it hasn't been, like, it's been 3 months, and then she's randomly contacted us, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, I think there's only so much you can do.
You can't keep putting your head out on the chopping block, kind of thing.
Head out on the chopping block. What was I going to say?
But what about for yourself? You've never been a part of anything, like?
No.
Well, you're smart.
No, I don't put myself in that situation or that position, because I think I'm smart enough to know that, I don't know.
You know what? Be like Crystal. Smart enough to know.
I just think after, like, my past, I don't think I could trust anybody again.
Which is what?
Huh?
After your past?
Yeah. Oh, like, breakups and stuff. I've done too many, so.
Would you not base that as like toxic?
That or ain't like toxic. It's just like it didn't work out.
Okay.
It didn't work out. So you broke up and that was just hard. And then like you've given everything you've had to that person. So you don't want to do it again?
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair enough.
So
I agree.
I completely just cut off every emotion that I had.
Do you feel that's good? A good thing?
Well, kind of. Like, I don't know. I just don't want to get hurt again.
So you don't get attached to anything?
Mm. So I just completely just cut off everything. And just do me.
Nice. Nice, nice. What's the next question?
What the heck? Weirdo. Hold up, let me see. Can you cut this part?
Yeah.
Oh, well, why am I just... Oh, yeah. What's your advice to anyone that may be in a toxic friendship relationship?
The faster you cut it, the faster you find yourself.
Yeah. Well, I had... Yeah, if you want to cut it, just cut it.
But that's the hardest part, is cutting it.
Yeah,
would be my advice. The faster you cut it, the faster you find yourself.
Yeah, there's nothing worse than to surround yourself with people that are negative and have the... that bring the wrong inno.
Inno.
That bring the wrong inno to the friendship.
Yeah, actually, that's true. Very true. Or they don't see the value in like what you want.
Yeah. Oh, I can feel toxicity.
Yeah, it's one. Between you and Bizza.
It gives me yucky vibes. I don't like it. Okay, so do you feel like now that you've come out of the other side, you've learned a few life lessons, and do you think it hinders you from creating and building new friendships?
I think you just touched on it before with what you said, you kind of don't want to attach yourself to people. So in a way, it did hinder for a long time.
Yeah.
I didn't really want to invest in any friendships really until I went to Warriors.
Yeah.
And 100%. I think at the time I was kind of like, nah, not invested in wanting to be anyone's friend. I was kind of just there for the lols.
Oh, I remember that. I remember that. I remember it like it was yesterday.
Yeah.
When you told me in my room at Manly, you came to me like, oh. I think you asked me what.
No, I said,
did you ask me why I'm here?
Yeah, something like that, maybe.
I'm pretty sure you asked me why I was here, and then you said, oh, no, I'm just here for the lols. I'm like, okay.
Yeah, but that was just like the headspace that I was in.
So you just on loan, like, cured them?
I was just on line with my emotions.
Oh, whoa. I just name dropped. Don't put that in. Cut that out.
But no, yeah, it definitely hindered my like way of like thinking, and I kind of just almost became real like self-absorbed. I only wanted to do things for myself. I only wanted to create whatever it was that was going to please me. But at the same time, I was like not open to anything. And then I went to Warriors, and that kind of opened my eyes to a whole different ball game, which I'm super grateful for, because now I have a pretty cool friend named Crystal. But yeah. Which I probably wouldn't have had if I didn't go there. I'd probably still be very much like, fuck the world.
Don't do that. Sorry.
Beep.
I've stopped doing the fingers. I used to do the fingers all the time. When did you ask?
Yeah. Anyway,
no, I think it. Yeah, I think toxic friendship. Yeah, if I was in one, I think it had.
Or even like, it doesn't even have to be like a.
I was just speaking.
A toxic friendship. It can just be like any relationship that's had, like, you know.
You're that person that found an effect on you.
Sorry, I'm just trying to let you know that you've. Anyway, keep going. Sorry.
Oh, rude. Wow, you just mind blanked me.
Sorry. That was my bad.
I was literally talking about.
You're talking about toxic friends.
Yeah, and then you just spoke over me.
Well, because I don't want. Okay, anyway. I don't want more toxic.
Okay, now that we've talked about toxic friendships, what do you think a healthy friendship looks like?
One that, like, well, I would say this friendship. You know,
no judgment, understanding, and support.
Wow, she just cut me off.
Yeah, well, you've done it to me. I want to answer this question.
Okay, you answer it.
Yeah, what does a healthy friendship look like to me? I think it looks like one another, understand each other, support each other, set goals, and they help each other achieve them. No judgment. What else do we have? Yeah, that's all I have right now.
Yeah, I agree. I definitely agree with that. There's just, it's like easy. It shouldn't, no friendship, I feel like now that I can like definitely like look at it, no friendship should be hard. If it's like hard to be in the friendship, then what are you doing? Kind of thing. Does that make sense?
What are you doing, Tazmin?
Help. No, joking. Nah.
I'm pressing the help button. Help me.
Well,
get me out of here.
Nah, if you're... can I be honest?
Oh, whoa.
That's why we're here. Anyway, I feel like, to me, this is what a healthy friendship is. Finally, I found one. One where you're, like, not... You can just be yourself. Like, I feel like the hardest thing in friendships is that
pretending people, to be pretending somebody to that be you're, not, you're not, or the person that they want you to be. Yeah. Fuck that.
Which is, like, obviously really easy, but, yeah, probably this is, like... I don't have to, like... be like, hey, can I be this type of person?
It's so easy to be myself around Tazmin.
Yeah, an idiot.
I'm just dumb, man. Just dumb.
Yeah, and I think I was so used to, like, having to, like... ask for like permission
to be who you wanted to be.
Yeah. To be like a certain type of friend or whatever.
And I think I don't need to stop you from being the person that you wanna be.
Yeah.
Like if you or do I?
No, but there's like a fine line. If I was being a dickhead, if I was like going out and doing dumb stuff, you'd be like, hey, like, you know? Any good friend would be like, pull you back into line kind of thing if you step out of line. That's not, I don't feel like that's judgment. I feel like that's just being a good mate. Yeah. Like any good friend would be. Which is why I think I like my circle, like my well, it's actually a triangle because there's only three people in it.
And I think like what makes a good friendship is doing like things that you both like to do. Like not if you like necessarily don't like the thing but the other person does, but you still do it to support them and what their happiness might be.
Yeah, just like having things in common is really cool.
Well, even if you don't have them in common, but you still just
compromise.
Yeah, like for us, what have we found? That
I don't like dancing, but Crystal likes dancing, so I pretend that I like dancing. But like it's funny.
She doesn't pretend.
It's actually funny.
She's not pretending. Funny. Oh my gosh. This morning I just caught her red handed. I was coming out of my room and I looked down, I was playing music. I looked down the hallway and she was on the wall going like this.
No, it wasn't.
And then she seen me and then she was like
I don't pretend.
But I like that. That's like that's her. It's authentic and it makes me laugh, and I don't know, I like it.
But yeah, no, that's probably what we've got, like.
Yeah, so I like dancing, she likes running, yeah. I do not like running.
I don't
running.
Really like running, I feel like I just have to run, but yeah, I probably like it more than you like it.
Yeah, well, she, yeah.
And so Crystal decided to run with me, but the thing is, if we run together, I can't run 50 metres ahead.
She's learned because the last other runs that we've run together, she's like 50 meters all the way in front of me and I'm at the back. No, wait, she said, oh, let's go run together. So I'm assuming together's like this. But hers is like this. So I kind of got pissed off and I just communicated that with her. And now she's like, okay.
I was always wondering why you wanted to run by yourself.
Yeah, because it's freaking annoying. Like, you may as well run by yourself. Don't ask me to come for a run with you if you're going to run 50 meters in front of you.
And one thing about good friendships is communication.
Yeah.
And that's what we're doing right now.
That's good though. But I think it brings like happiness.
Hard.
In our soul.
And that's what I feel like friendships are for, you know.
We also, well, one more. We also we're reading together. We, instead of like on our phones on the drive, we'll
which is a freaking long drive to the school.
Yeah, so it's like about 40 minutes to drop the kids off, so we'll read 40 minutes. And now we're reading The Resilience Project by, what's his name? Dan?
Hugh.
Oh, yeah. Hugh Van Cullenberg, I think. Cullenberg.
It's on.
Yeah. So
if you like reading books, read it. It's helped, I think it's helped us, like, reset in a way. Because sometimes you get kind of caught up in the whole, what you're doing in life. But anyway, that's what we're doing to better our friendship.
Yeah.
But yeah.
That's it. Is it?
Yeah, so all in all, I feel like don't get down on yourself if you're in a toxic friendship. Yeah. Just
open up about it. Talk to someone about it. Don't think that it's okay for you to be in that, because it's not.
Yeah, hard. Like, know your worth as a person, as well as obviously you love people and you love the friends that you have around you. But at the same time, they can be the quickest things to pull you down. So my advice
is what's your advice?
My advice would be just like, remember who you are. And look to the friends that, like, you know, that have always valued you as a person, rather than what you're doing for them. So that would be my advice, and just like, keep talking, peeps, just keep talking.
I wrote something actually for Tazmin the other day. Or did I write it for you? Or just in general?
You wrote it. No, you just said, hey, read it. Read this.
Should I read it? Yeah. It's actually good advice.
Yeah. You got it?
Yeah. All right, here we go.
Why? Closing remarks.
Okay. Stop settling for less than you deserve. Life can be blissful. It can be a struggle. You decide by the decisions you make. Personal development and self-care is the bridge between the life you have now and the life which you dream of. So make yourself your highest priority. Invest in yourself, believe in yourself, and start discovering what you're truly worth. Life is an adventure, so make it an exciting one that you'll look back on one day and know that you lived it to your fullest. Ka kite anō.